So I am warning you, don't make a mistake of going to a church and doing that. Because it is a curse that you are building to yourself and your children. And that curse, no one will break the curse, because it is God that comes to break curses. So if you come to church and begin to threaten, stop threatening even pastors and bishops. Don't threaten them. Because some of them will begin to curse you and it will work against you. Don't threaten them, because microchips. You know, they are running. These microchips are the things they want to insert into people before time elapses. And that's the contest between Trump and Biden. Because it's a contest between God and Satan. Yes. So I want to advise the government that as you come into power again, because it was just by an inch, you people, you are going home.
Of the last thing, and then to malize,
yes.
You made a prophecy about President Ruto. Recently, I saw the prophecy that you saw the president's seat empty. Tell us more about that prophecy, the one you made recently.
Okay, so what happens is that when God reveals, he reveals to redeem. Anytime God is speaking, he reveals his mysteries to redeem. So that was actually a vision I saw while I was sleeping. It was in the dream, but it came as a vision. I saw the seat of the president was empty. And that there were many things I saw I didn't speak about. I saw the army, it was divided and it had taken over. And people were running in confusion. I saw children and I saw women in the camps. And the Lord told me, you have to rise up and pray over this thing and warn the president. Because one thing I like about the president is that I think he is seeing these videos. Because anytime we speak, I see him making changes based on the advice we are giving him. Because I saw it and I told him he should run with speed and appoint those two CSs. I said he should go ahead and appoint the Minister for Defense and Minister for Interior Security. And I have seen among the list, he has appointed them.
Yeah.
He has appointed them, which means that he's watching these things. Because if he did not run, what happened is that there was a very serious conspiracy to overthrow his government, because there are a few people who don't like him. They had seen his weakness after what happened with the Gen Z's. I think they looked at him and they said, oh, this man, kumbe, we can push him. We used to think he was this big-hearted man. But the way we are looking at him is like, if we put in a little bit of energy, this man is going to surrender.
Yeah.
And that's where the president was going. I am telling you, there were two things. Either the army was going to take over or the president was going to surrender. He was going to resign. So God told me I should tell him to press and become a man, the man that was elected. Because every leader, they are put into leadership by God. Yes. And that's what I saw him now. The following day on Monday, he came out so strong. He was in rallies and he was talking with power. And you can see God has helped him. Even the opposition leader was denying that there's no dialogue. I saw him now. He has come to agreement and he's saying we are going to have dialogue and we need to support the president. And that's the way we should go. That's the way we should go, because they should give. I feel, in my opinion, that the president meant good for this country. But the problem is that the people who are close to him, they are misadvising him. Remember in that prophecy, I said he should be careful with his advisors. There are so many young men who have proximity to him, and these people are the one who are speaking things that are not good. Yes. And I think he has done it. He has followed the advice and he's doing changes, very good changes here and there. And I'm very sure that with the cabinet that is bringing up, the country is going to soldier on. We are going to a good place. Yes.
But besides electing new cabinet secretaries or rather new cabinet members, the Gen Z's or rather the Kenyans are not happy with the few people that have been taken back to that particular group of cabinet secretaries. Aden Duale is back and Kindiki is there. You know, Kenyans are not happy. They are saying that they are going back to the streets to demonstrate.
No. Let me tell you. I want to address the Gen Z's because you see what is happening is that when you look at Duale, I think, is a loyalist to the president. When you look at Kindiki, he's also a loyalist. Remember when they were going into election, he was to choose between Gachagua and Kindiki, who become the deputy. So there is no way he can do away with even if you are the one. Even these DNCs who are running up and down, even if they were in that position, you'll be forced to pick to bring him back. And number two, Kindiki is also a performer. It's just that most people doesn't know him. They want people to speak with a louder voice for that position. But he's also a performer. Number two, Kindiki is also very educated. He's a man with a high level of education, and his reasoning is very, very good. I am sure that these are the people that, are, if they are around the president is going to make good decisions. And I'm very sure that the president knows those people who are misadvising him, and that's why he's putting them aside. The likes of Akina Murkomen, the likes of Akina, you know, Moses Kuria. Yeah, these are people who don't care about the rest of the Kenyans. But I believe that Kindiki and Adan Duale, they are they still qualify to be in those positions. And I'm very sure that we together with the president, they will steer this country ahead. Yeah, so the agencies, you have to be, sometimes these things, as much as you are demanding, you have to understand also at some level that there are people, you cannot go alone. You know, if the president does not pick them, you will remain a lone ranger. And being alone, you will not be able to perform well. You need friends around you also. But friends that will help you to achieve your objectives. Yes.
As a man of God, can you talk to the government and all people concerned?
So I want to address the government. One thing, the government of Kenya, I want you to know that this country, with the kind of taxes that you are collecting, the money you collect every year is able to take care of this country if we can manage those resources well. Kenya does not have any problem. The problem with Kenya is that we have had a lot of corruption, embezzlement of funds. That's what has been going on. And when people are stealing, they want to steal too much. The problem with Kenya is that people want to compare themselves with their predecessors. For example, when Ruto comes, he wants to be richer than Uhuru. People want to amass wealth left, right, center, at the expense of the common man. So I want to speak to the government that if you can run this country well, we don't need to go outside there to beg for aid. We don't need to go outside there to borrow money. If we can have good leadership, we don't need to go to America and beg them to help us. And number two, I want to advise the president that America is not a country to help Kenya. America is not after helping us. America is after enslaving Africans. And I said something about the president. You know, when he became the president, he went out in Africa and he was saying how we need to be free from the white men. That was the genesis of his problems, if you are not aware. That's where his problems are coming from. If you want to prove to those guys that you know much, that you can bring reparation in Africa, that you can change the livelihood of the people, they will deal with you. And that's how they are dealing with him. Yes, that's how they are dealing with him. So their agenda is not good. Number one, they are fighting. Spiritually, they are running very fast because they are running out of time. They want to establish one world order. We will talk about that maybe next time when we meet. They want to establish one world order. And they are seeing Kenya as a potential country. If it works in Kenya, it can work everywhere.
Yeah.
Yes. I saw even when he came back, he was saying that Microsoft, they have given him over $1 billion. They want to build an ICT center in Naivasha. You see, they are really working hard. It's not an ICT center. And he's talking about microchips. You know, that's they are running. These microchips are the things they want to insert into people before time elapses. And that's the contest between Trump and Biden. Because it's a contest between God and Satan. Yes. So I want to advise the government that as you come into power again, because it was just by an inch, you people, you are going home. So God has given you another chance. Please serve Kenyans with all your heart. Make sure that you give your best. Let us cut off corruption completely. Let us use the public funds well. And God is going to help you, because as a church, our role is to pray for the leadership. And we are praying for the leadership of the day. We are not into politics. When you see me prophesying, I'm not on any side. In fact, I don't vote because I don't want to be on any side. I want to be on the side of God.
Neutral.
Yes, I want to be neutral. Yes, you wanted me to advise the government and who else?
And I think the government and the people concerned.
I want to talk to the people concerned, particularly those who are on the streets. I understand that the Gen Zs had a very good intention for this country. But now we have goons that have taken over. Mm. We have people like Akina Boniface Mwangi who are paid by people. Everyone knows that these people are paid, they are sponsored. So they want to take advantage of the whole thing. So what is happening is that I want to advise you that this country belongs to all of us. And if we let this country to burn down, all of us are going to be hurt. Mm. Yes, nobody will open a border for you to go to Uganda or to go to Tanzania. So, you know, people in Kenya, we have had peace all through. People have never been refugees. People have never been in camps. So they don't know what it means to be in a camp. They don't know what it means to be a refugee in a foreign land. So I want to advise you that the government, which is led by our president, has taken into consideration your grievances and is addressing them slowly by slowly. So please, let us give him time. We have gone to the streets. He withdrew the finance bill. He has made changes in the government. Let us give him time so that he works out. Let us see where he's going. And if you want to remove the president, wait until 2027. I want to advise particularly the youth, go and get your voting card so that when it comes to 2027, you have a weapon to take him away if you want to take him out. Let us not go the way you are going of the streets. It is not going to help us. In fact, what is going to happen is that what I saw a few days ago, I saw many youth on the street. If you continue with this, what is going to happen, the order to shoot to kill is going to be given, and many youth are going to fall by the roadside. So I want to warn you, the youth, please, the Genesis, we have heard you. So what you need to do, you have to withdraw and let us give the present time. And then something else I will talk about the Genesis is that you have to respect the church, because I have heard you also saying that you want to occupy churches. Please be warned, because if you touch the church, those curses, you are bringing it to your own children and yourselves. Because the church is not a place where you can go and occupy. When you are dealing matters with God, you don't use your strength to come and fight God. So I am warning you, don't make a mistake of going to a church and doing that. Because it is a curse that you are building to yourself and your children. And that curse, no one will break the curse, because it is God that comes to break curses. So if you come to church and begin to threaten, stop threatening even pastors and bishops. Don't threaten them, because some of them will begin to curse you and it will work against you. Don't threaten them, because pastors have a way, they have been anointed by God. Their words never fall on the ground. When they begin to curse you, it will be another story. Yes.
Thank you so much, Prophet.
Yes.
And maybe a word of encouragement to my fans. Tumalizena hiyo.
I want to encourage you that Martin is doing a very good job, and I want you to run quickly to come and subscribe to this channel. Help him to grow. For a long time, we have not had media that are coming to church to see, to collect views on the church. But I want to pray for you that you are going to measure most in the church. There is a very big opportunity that has not been exploited. So I want to pray for you that if you can take over and begin to go to churches and ask people, that men of God outside there, they will have views, but there's no one going there. I'm telling you, it's going to blow out. And I'm praying for a YouTube channel that is going to flourish. So I want to pray that people are going to follow you. Those who have not subscribed, is it just on YouTube alone?
On YouTube, TikTok, all of
you are also, what is your channel on TikTok?
My name is the same name, Martin Din.
Oh, Martin. Okay, so you can search for him on TikTok and Facebook and follow him. Yes, go and follow Prophet Matthew Israel also on YouTube. And we are praying for you. Martin, I realize many people don't understand the prophetic. I think next time, if we are going to have another discussion, I want to talk to people about fivefold ministry, to explain to them and where each one of them falls, because it's like even our fathers of the land don't understand where the prophetic falls. Mm-hmm. Yes.
This is home. I'll get back here.
Amen.
Since
Amen.
This is my first day, and also I have a pastor.
Yes.
That is called Pastor Israel.
Oh, okay.
Johanna is also a lawyer.
Oh.
So it's like I'm bonding Burale. With Israel.
Oh, Pastor Burale Israel.
Not really. He's called Israel Johanna. He's
Johanna
coming from
Israel.
Kangundo Road.
Oh, okay. Yeah. He's in Kangundo Road. Wow. Glory be to God.
Yeah.
We are going to bond, because as men of God, I think it's high time we come together and champion towards one goal. Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'll get back here.
Amen.
Asante sana mtumishi.
Yes.
And I'm praying that God will be able to bring me back here. I come see your content too. Nakuja na dance, na imba. I'm also a worshiper.
Wow.
So
you are a worshiper. We invite you to come and worship with us one of these days.
Yeah.